Alright, today on Ultra Collector Custom, I'm going to show you guys how you do this the right way. How you add color to your pistols. First off, I'll start by just showing you a couple custom things. This is a real backplate from a real Glock. They'll only fit on the VFC Gen 4s. It'll probably work on the 18 as well. But all the other Glocks have a single... The backplate is connected to the base of the whole air system. So you can't, the plate isn't just a plate. It's connected to the whole frame of your cylinder. Excuse me. Okay, so let's get into it. The way you get this, look how beautiful and perfect this looks. You know, you don't want to use crayon. Crayon will, you know, especially like even in the cleaning process, the crayon will, like a car wax, will wear down the finish, this kind of rough finish that's on these pistols. They're either Cerakoted or powder coated, so they have a rough finish. But if you use a crayon, what will happen is you'll start wearing all this down to where it's shiny. So you'll end up having shiny circles and ovals around your work. You know, this will be evident when you go to clean the pistol. There's no turning around from that. That's there forever because you have, in essence, worn down the base of the finish of these, of your work. You know what I mean? So stay away from crayons. You're like waxing a car when you put crayon on this. You're actually making it shiny. You're wearing down that rough finish. With this, we're using opaque paints. Learn about paints, the differences between enamels, lacquers, opaque paints, water-based, oil-based. If you want to start customizing pistols, you need to learn about those. You need to learn that enamels do not dry. You cannot use enamels on rubber. They will never dry. They'll remain sticky for its lifetime. Lacquer paints are great. Lacquer paints is what we use on car bodies, on metal, on plastic. If your plastic's too thin, lacquer will eat into thin plastic. But lacquer dries quick. You know, it has a great finish, a smooth finish, because it's a lot thinner than enamel paints. Enamel paints are really thick. That's why we use enamel paints on plastic models. It won't eat into the plastic, but what it does is create a very thick and blobby type finish if you don't know how to paint with them. So, you know, if you use enamel on an airbrush, we always add paint thinner to them. If you use lacquer, you can just go right from lacquer into an airbrush and it'll work. So here we go. All you do is the first thing you need, the most important thing, is you need alcohol prep pads, okay? And you'll take alcohol prep pads, and as you can see, these are only 70% isopropyl. So isopropyl alcohol, if you go any higher than that, it's not good for the finish, okay? It's not good for your skin either, but this is perfectly fine for your skin. This is what doctors and hospitals use to clean areas before they give you an injection or something. So before you add paint, you'll go in, you'll go crossways, you'll go side by side, up and down, in little circles, and you'll do each individual spot. Do not go like this. And do not add a lot of pressure, okay? If you do, you're going to end up wearing this finish down as well, you know? So just go up and down, just get around in there so that you're cleaning inside these little areas, okay? As you can see with the red one, I even did these little red dots. And with opaque paints, especially, you want to find medium. This is the viscosity. This is made by painters. It's an opaque paint. It's medium viscosity, meaning it's not too runny. It's not too thick. It's right in between. But it is thin enough to get in these little tiny spaces. I mean, look at that. That little teeny Glock sign. It's vivid and distinct, you know, and it's not affected by oil. I even did the slide on the blue one here, and, I mean, it's beautiful. You cannot do that with a crayon, okay? A crayon doesn't last that long. This will last as long as you want it to. As soon as you want to change colors or you want this gone away, you just take another alcohol prep pad. It can be a year later. This will last forever until you take an alcohol prep pad and scrub it away. This will clean back to perfect again. But if you get your nail down inside there and you scratch this thing while using a prep pad, it will scratch this paint off. So you don't want to do that. You know what I mean? Unless your intention is to make all this look aluminum. You know what I mean? Then you can take a utensil and you can use alcohol and you can scratch into these letters and make them kind of a chrome finish. I wouldn't do that. I mean, being that I've done things like that before, I could do that, but I wouldn't do that. I think this is the best method to use. You buy these markers at any hobby store. This came from Hobby Lobby. You can order it online. They will come to you. They're $7. You get all your primary colors, your red, blue, yellow, red, and white. Whites are really thin, real watery looking, so kind of a clearish color. So it'll take a number of goes for you to get this vivid of a job done. Okay, so first thing you do is you wipe and clean this really good, especially if you oil and clean your guns like I do really often. And then you just want to take your marker. It has a regular tip, and you just want to, you know, you press the tip in on a paint marker, and that's what kind of brings the paint from inside the can into the brush area of your marker. And you want to, you know, go draw around in these lines, but make it just keep it in there. Don't let it get out wild and crazy, because you have a cleanup job to do after. So you want to make sure you kind of flood each one of these lines really good. Go back and forth just like you did with the alcohol pad. Do it with the marker. Do each one individually. Let it dry maybe 10-15 minutes, okay? After that, you want to take another alcohol pad. Oh, and you want to kind of squeeze the alcohol. You don't want this dripping wet when you go to do this second process. If you do, you'll flood the blue paint, and it will just mix with your alcohol and turn all this blue. It will be able to be cleaned up again, so don't worry, but it's going to make things 10 times harder than they need to be. You need to separate the slide from the frame, because you don't want to get this mess inside your frame. All this graininess of these frames, very hard to clean, and again, you don't want to ruin the finish by smoothing this out, which you will if you end up scrubbing too hard. So you rinse out your alcohol pad after you have these all completely covered in color, and then you'll just wipe, okay? And you'll lightly wipe. You need no pressure at all. Literally, just the pressure of it touching will start to wipe away all that color. And you'll see it kind of get everywhere because the alcohol and the paint will mix. But what you're looking for is just to get it so that you have no more disfiguration of your numbers and your letters. Once that happens, let that dry, even though there'll be kind of a blue, wipey mess everywhere. And once that dries, you'll get another alcohol pad, you'll rinse it, you'll do the exact same thing. You'll go over and start doing the cleanup process. That process is, you know, you may do a wipe or two around this, but you don't want to wipe your paint up that's inside here. But, you know, start cleaning up the outside, wherever paint has run, you know what I mean? And start cleaning all that up. And once you clean all that up, that's your process. It will, the air dries it itself. If you see anything after what you think is your last process, then just get an alcohol swab, drain it again. Or if it's a far away from these areas, then you don't have to drain it. You just wipe it clean. You know what I mean? And it's that simple. You can do your bags. I mean, this is one I did where I just messed around, you know, but I did all the lettering and I made it so that just the outside of the back of what would look like the back of your rounds painted. On this one, I did the whole thing and I filled in and did all the numbers. And this mag is covered in oil. So, I mean, this shows you that oil does not mess up your job. You know what I mean? The opaque paints work well with oil and cleaning materials, you know what I mean? So you just wouldn't be able to do this with enamels, like an enamel paint marker. I have before, and it's 10 times harder to remove the paint and get it to stay inside these, you know, your work. So just do like this. You know, in case you're curious, this is an adapter, so I could put a tracer on there. With this, I did the gold salient arms threaded barrel. And I did a gold steel guide rod made by Kowkow. These parts were ordered from Red Wolf Airsoft. They work perfect in the Gen 4, or in the 18C. They will work in a Gen 4 as well. On the website, it says they're made for a Gen 5, but it doesn't work in the Gen 5. There's too many issues. The arm, the wing that's inside the outer barrel. The fact that they have this type of hop-up where you adjust it from the end on both. Here's the Gen 5, which is a gorgeous gun. The best triggers of all the Glocks is a Gen 5, an 18C, and the 19X. The good 19X that takes this mag, the gas mag. The CO2 mag version of this is a half blowback. Do not buy that one. That's the one that has a double trigger. It's nothing like a real Glock. It has an aluminum topped mag, and the top is actually your trigger. And so the trigger pulls terrible. It's all around. It can't be field stripped, nothing. This is the good version, okay? You want to make sure you get the green gas version with the small mag. Full blowback. This is becoming one of my most favorite guns I own. So, yeah, threaded barrel. I do these custom tips. These are for real steel guns. They are anodized. I'm anodizing them in blue, chrome, red, and then I have them in a black as well, which, let's see if I got one on hand really quick. Here we go. These right here, these are solid steel, where these are aluminum, okay? So I am going to start selling these on my site. They'll probably be around $14 to $16, and, you know, shipping won't cost anything. I'll just stick them in an envelope with some stamps and ship them to you. And you can pay however. You'll just have to subscribe to my channel, comment, let me know if you want one or not. If you have any questions about this, comment and ask. I'll immediately answer you. If you want a video of something, of me doing something, I'll make it for you, okay? So, my channel, my videos, all us that do YouTube, these are all videos for you guys. These aren't for us, you know? These videos are to help you guys. So, you know, we want your comments and your questions and your and what you want to know. You know, this is what we do this for. So, this is Crisis Chris from Ultra Collector Custom, and I hope you enjoyed the video. And I hope it helps. Take care. Bye.